Few people realize the ominous connection between serial killer Charles Manson and the Son of Sam. If Charles Manson is the most notorious serial killer on the West Coast, David Berkowitz, known as the Son of Sam, is the most infamous serial killer on the East Coast. New York City began to truly live up to its name as the city that never sleeps, as David Berkowitz gunned down his victims over a number of months. The Son of Sam was merciless and unrelenting as he continued to pile up victims and frustrate New York City law enforcement. Many in law enforcement know, though, that the Son of Sam murders were done by more than Berkowitz alone.
If Son of Sam was a nut job, why are there three cars, five different descriptions, different height, different shapes, different sizes of the perpetrator? If somebody else was there.
After being captured, David Berkowitz would eventually admit that he was a Satanist working with the same satanic cult that Charles Manson was affiliated with, known as the Process.
They were high-level occultists, high-level Satanists, high-level Process people.
Approximately how many people were at this meeting, all told?
Well, maybe...
In rough numbers.
A couple dozen.
And Process members and leaders were there too, and they struck up the plan.
I had sold myself to the devil. I was in the infantry in the United States Army, and you were trained if you got caught. You just give the enemy your name, rank, and serial number. And that's what Satan does to you.
Berkowitz had given addresses and pictures of his family to cult members and explained that their process was to kill family members if he was disloyal.
I was concerned for my family too, you know. And
if they feel you are endangering their organization, in my heart, they would hold no punches about killing you.
Like serial killer Charles Manson, Berkowitz had willingly given his soul to the devil.
I had sold myself to the devil. Satan had been reaching out to me. He had chosen me for something. He was preparing the way for me to do something for him long before I even had any knowledge of his existence, you see. And it just seemed like everything that happened it was like destiny. It was my destiny. I just feel this powerful force was just moving me along to just push me in that direction. Somebody had told me to get a copy of the Satanic Bible. I didn't even know there was such a thing as a Satanic Bible. And he told me to go to a bookstore. It's in any bookstore. I went and got a copy of that and began to read it. And things began to change. It's like a power or a force began to actually reach out to me and kind of take charge over my life, kind of move me along. It was a process that took a while, and I did begin to take vows. I had begun to be partaker of the group with chanting and rituals and various incantations. There were animal sacrifices and other dark and ugly things happening.
Like Charles Manson, who also associated with the process, Berkowitz acknowledged that they were seeking to foster an atmosphere of lawlessness to help facilitate the emergence of the Antichrist.
And this was a time when they began to think about maybe even taking human lives. Human sacrifices. We believe that the devil's right-hand man, his key player in these like end times or so forth, is going to come on the scene one day. Our idea was to create atmosphere where there's lawlessness and disorder everywhere.
Berkowitz said of the satanic cult he belonged to that they are, quote, secretive and bonded together by a common need and a desire to mete out havoc on society. He said it was Aleister Crowley who said, "I want blasphemy, murder, rape, revolution, anything bad. Surely you will agree that death literally followed Crowley's footsteps," end quote. When Berkowitz revealed the place where they were conducting their satanic rituals, they not only found evidence of animal sacrifices, but they found symbols like those used in the Church of Satan, upside-down pentagrams, and inverted crosses. Berkowitz admitted of the cult's satanic practices, quote, "This group contained a mixture of satanic practices which included the teachings of Aleister Crowley. It was, still is, totally blood-oriented. The coven's doctrines are a blend of ancient Druidism, which we've seen mentioned by Charles Manson, and the teachings of the Golden Dawn, a group to which Aleister Crowley belonged, and black magic." When the site was later investigated, amidst the satanic graffiti, this piece of paper was found, declaring, quote,
"Woe to you, O earth and sea. For the devil sends the beast with wrath, because he knows the time is short. Let him who hath understanding reckon the number of the beast, for it is a human number. Its number is 666.
The words that you just heard were taken from an album by the popular heavy metal band Iron Maiden. This declaration from the album precedes an Iron Maiden song which speaks of ritual sacrifice and the emergence of the number of the Antichrist. Incredibly, next to the black pentagram and the painted, inverted crosses were the chilling words, quote, "I will return." Apparently these words, "I will return," were taken from another Iron Maiden song that follows on the foot of the one just mentioned, called The Number of the Beast, a song about sacrifice, another evidence of the influence of music in Satanism. Iron Maiden admitted a year earlier that their music had been influenced by Aleister Crowley. In the Son of Sam letters, they left strange symbols that included an upside-down or inverted cross, and they made special reference to Beelzebub, or Satan, their father.
Some of those same people I dealt with, I arrested for promoting prostitution by selling me children for $20 for sex, were later identified as being members in 1976, or affiliates or associates of the process.
One person who David Berkowitz implicated was that of record producer Roy Radin. Radin was extremely wealthy and owned a notorious estate on Long Island. Berkowitz admitted that when they sacrificed Stacy Moskowitz, their plan was to turn it into a snuff film. Berkowitz acknowledged that one of the three men in the film filming the murder was an associate of Roy Radin's. Ron Sisman is the one who is believed to have photographed Moskowitz's sacrifice.
Yeah, some big people wanted to get in on that, and they had some other... There's some other people taking care of that as far as making arrangements.
They will see the film later on for a set fee. I understand some of those snuff films go for like $50,000.
This time when the sacrifice had been made, this is all, you know, part of the ritual and everything, and there was some filming going on. Somebody wanted to film it for somebody else.
Jesse Turner, a self-confessed process hitman, admitted that he was contracted to kill Ron Sisman by a world-renowned artist.
Who approached you to take care of Ron Sisman?
Robert Mapleton.
Why?
Because Ron Sisman had possession of some snuff film.
The only way that you could get out of this thing was either they killed you off, you killed yourself off with a suicide. Okay. That was the only way to get carried out in a pine box.
So in depth that it would take an army of police officers, or it would take somebody with power, guts, and influence to shut these guys down.
As we can see, the fruit of occultic practices is that of death, murder, and suicide, and eventually eternal damnation in hell. David Berkowitz warned young people of the danger of dabbling in the occult.
Like they're losing their fear of the devil, and this is a grooming process. A lot of kids today have no concept whatsoever of the dangers that are involved in any form of the occult, how quickly a bondage could form, how quickly a person's mind and spirit could be taken over by some kind of